in the emerging global economy, competitiveness in the market space has become a mantra. So India requires an innovation model which suits our requirements of both being competitive globally and sensitive nationally.
It is in this context that micro, small and medium enterprises, or MSMEs, need special attention. After all, there are around 26 million MSMEs providing employment to over 60 million people. But these MSMEs face significant challenges when it comes to innovations.
I think there are three broad kinds of or levels of challenges. The first one is about the ignorance of what are the frontiers that are available to them and what they can necessarily achieve. The second one is about framing a methodology of how to go about innovating. And the third one is finding the right resources, ways and means to achieve that.
Innovation in the context of MSMEs and their clusters would include introduction of new products, processes, designs, systems, services and markets. It would also have to include low-cost incremental improvements in production and processes.
The Government of India, through its various ministries and institutions, has already been supporting innovation at the enterprise level by giving them necessary support and also by creating local infrastructure. However, this invaluable support needs to be supplemented and complemented by ensuring that the local ecosystem and actors there can essentially work together to unleash the potential which already waits to be unfolded. And this is what is called cluster development approach towards innovation.
This is precisely what the Program for Promoting Innovation in Clusters set out to achieve.
The Department of Science and Technology works for development of technologies. We had been trying to promote technologies through various means. And one of the means we thought was that if we work in an industrial cluster where there are already existing units, there'll be people who would try and emulate the examples of a successful technology implementation, that not only innovative technologies, innovative processes, innovative designs, and even innovative business models could actually help them scale their businesses quicker and faster.
The program chose 6 clusters in 3 sectors for implementation. The foundry clusters in Samalkha, Kethal and Faridabad in Haryana, the life sciences clusters in Ahmedabad and Hyderabad, and the information and communication technology cluster in the National Capital Region of Delhi.
Our approach to the program was first to go in the cluster and find out what necessarily were the key challenges that could necessarily be taken care of through innovations. This we call as diagnosis. The second one was to then organize the seekers and the service providers so that they can interact on a platform to understand each other's requirements. And the third one was to actually make linkages and provide the necessary means so that the problems could essentially be taken care of.
One of the first decisive steps taken by the program was to get entrepreneurs to form their own associations or revitalize existing ones. These associations have now become important vehicles for fostering innovations. With the help of FMC, they have organized training programs and mentoring sessions. Members have also participated in trade fairs and visited other clusters in order to expand their horizons. As a result of all these activities, the entrepreneurs have started generating new ideas. Shishish Jain, an ICT entrepreneur who visited the Dehradun Pharmaceutical Cluster, gives an example.
We came out with an innovative idea that temperature and pressure monitoring is one of the key missing pieces which they would require as an innovative product to be developed, and for which we have already developed a prototype, have done a trial or pilot demo to them, and probably will go into a full-fledged production in some time to come.
Innovative ideas often get stalled by technical hurdles, and MSMEs do not have any idea who to turn to for cost-effective solutions. That's why the program initiated the Institute Industry Innovation Cells, or IIIC. Today, two pharmacy colleges in Hyderabad host IIIC cells. Their coordinators, both senior faculty members, work along with their students and execute projects brought to them by the pharmaceutical MSMEs.
IIIC is like a blessing for our small-scale industry, wherein they give a complete solution, better solution, technology-wise and cost-effective solution to us.
The program also recognized that many innovations do not see the light of day. The reason is very simple.
You know, we have great technologists and innovators, but who do not have much business sense.
And yet, there are many bright business school students who can produce competent business plans.
And bringing them, these two sets of people together, is what Metamorphosis is all about.
Metamorphosis awards were given to teams of management students who came out with outstanding business plans for specific innovative ideas. Some of the business plans awarded were for innovative ideas like a robotic arm for laparoscopic surgeries, an affordable communication device for non-verbal people, and a water-based spermicidal contraceptive. Metamorphosis was organized by the IKP Knowledge Park and the Indian School of Business. Bringing such institutions together has been an important component of the program. For instance, the Gujarat State Biotechnology Mission supported the Entrepreneurship Development Institute of India, which executed the Biotechnopreneur program. This initiative provides invaluable training inputs to those who are keen on starting knowledge-driven life sciences enterprises.
In all, 19 persons joined the program. And it's quite encouraging to see that 14 have already prepared their business plans and roadmap. Three have already set up the enterprises, and remaining 11 are in the process of setting up enterprises.
But what happens to this biotechnopreneur training initiative once the program for promoting innovation in clusters finishes its term?
We will take it further, we'll do the handholding, because I feel that from this stage onwards, all the participants and future startups will be needing the support. So GSB team will continue to carry in the program with all support which is possible and linkage with other agencies as well.
The program was also aware that innovative solutions to problems often lie within the very clusters themselves. For instance, slag generated by the Samalkha foundries used to get dumped all over town. Not anymore. The Foundry Association has now tied up with a local tile manufacturer who takes all the waste slag and converts it into tiles. He also recovers iron from the slag and sells it back to the foundries.
इसमें सर हमारे दो फायदे हैं ये. एक तो हम इसको क्रश करके टाइल में यूज करते हैं, टाइल की अच्छी रिक्वायरमेंट है. दूसरा जो आयरन और निकलती है ये इसको वापस इसको फाउंड्री वालों को भेज देते हैं.
On their own, SMEs may not have the resources to hire specialized consultants, but their associations, with all the pooled and resources, can. This is precisely what the Foundry Association in Samalkha has done. They hired an industrial designer, and together they have come up with a modern chaff cutter. This is what the cluster makes now, and this is the newly designed one.
अभी फाउंडेशन की हेल्प से हमने चाफ कटर के नए डिजाइन डेवलप किए हैं. 8 मशीनें बनाई हैं. उन चाफ कटर को हमने ट्राई करके देखा है, जो कि 100% सक्सेस हैं. अब उसकी मार्केटिंग के लिए गुजरात और महाराष्ट्र की हम ट्राई करेंगे.
Clearly, the program has planted seeds for fostering innovations, and these seeds have started germinating. The evidence? Entrepreneurs in the program area have started taking their own initiatives. Tarun Bhalla, an ICT entrepreneur, gives an example.
We were looking for a touch screen panel. We did not have the cycles to develop it in-house. Thereby, we got in touch with Mr. Vinay Chadda, who is also a fellow entrepreneur. And he not only developed the solution for us, but also helped with the development of the software.
Tarun got in touch with me for development of a touch screen controller. After I developed the touch screen controller for him, I liked that idea very much. And I developed another product using same technology. This product is home lighting controller based on same technology. And we are selling it in a reasonably large volume nowadays.
But doing well in the market may mean innovative sales strategies. This is Atul Gangwar, who makes, among other products, robust LED lanterns.
The LED lanterns are costly for a rural person. Through Niti Network, I have come across a microfinance entrepreneur. They have a significant presence in the rural areas. So we would like to tie up with them so that a villager can afford a lantern through a loan from a microfinance company.
There is evidence then that the clusters are beginning to respond with innovative ideas. This is a process which will be sustained by the associations, the funding institutions, and the knowledge organizations that have participated in the program. And the lessons learned from this initiative can feed into other programs as well.
With India marching on its developmental path, a lot of work has already begun in this area. National Innovation Council, under the leadership of Mr. Sam Pitroda, has already undertaken pilot work in 9 clusters. 40 more are likely to be started very soon. Ministry of MSME is already preparing a scheme in order to ensure that many more clusters can be taken up to foster innovation there. TIFAC, Department of Science and Technology, Council of Scientific Industrial Research, Department of Biotechnology, and many other institutions have already given directives to their local institutions to focus their work on cluster level. And I'm sure that this project, Learnings, will essentially feed into many of these works which have now begun to unfold.